Hey there, this is Wendy with loveandstampin.com. Really quick before we start, I want to show you my October special. If you use the host code and order $100 or more, you get this stamp set for free. So let's jump into today's projects. Maybe you'll see something here that you want to purchase to go towards that $100 order. All right, so we've got the Menagerie mix-up. And some fun colors. Our color splash this week is Old Olive, Crumb Cake, and Real Red, and White. So I'm going to be doing a bunch of stamping here. I'm using Stays On Ink, and I'm stamping out, I'm sorry, this isn't Stays On Ink. It's Memento Tuxedo Black Ink, because I'm using alcohol markers. So I'm going to stamp out a whole bunch of these, but don't fret. I'm only going to color one just for time's sake because this video is already super long and I already edited it down to cut out some stuff and speed up some things. But I love a long video because it always gives us time to chit chat and catch up, but we'll get into that in a little bit. So I put out a message on Instagram and asked what people, and on my Facebook, what animal people would like me to see, would like for me to create with. Words are hard. So I got a pretty good response of the deer, the reindeer. So I decided that this color splash would go perfect using this reindeer. And so that's what I did. But I didn't want to just make one card because I already had it all out. I already had the images on clear blocks. So I decided to stamp multiples of all the things. So that's what you're seeing here. I decided to leave it in the video just to make sure this video was long enough for us to still have chit chat story time. Speaking of that, this is my disclaimer. If you are not interested in hearing the chit chat, you can do two things. You can either click off the video or you can mute it. Some people don't like that and that's okay. Probably not the best channel for you though, gotta admit. If that's something that bothers you. In fact, I think there's multiple people that just come here to hear story time and chit chat that don't really even care what I'm creating. So anyway, I did cheat on this color splash and I used the bronze marker, Blends marker, because I wanted to create some shadows. And I discovered I don't have a light crumb cake marker. I no idea what happened to it. So, yeah, I need to order one. So I'm going to have to order some new blends. I've been going through my blends, cleaning them up, getting my labels on them. Speaking of which, if you want labels, they are below, linked below this video. They are a digital download now. I have not printed my own to mail out in some time. I'm not really interested in doing that right now. I've got too much going on. So if you want a digital download of the Stampin' Blends labels, you can get it below the video. I've heard a lot of people do that and then they just use a glue dot to adhere the label to the end of the blend. Or you could print it on label paper. That works too. Okay, so I'm just going through adding some shadows in some spots that need them and going to do a cool trick with my marker, with my Real Red marker here that I definitely want you to see and we'll talk about a little bit. So I'm adding a little bit of shadows. Generally speaking, I pretend like my light source is coming from the right-hand side. I don't know why, I just do. And it's easier for me to shade or shadow in a way that it's like consistent so that I remember how to do it versus trying to change it up all the time. If you are a person who loves the alcohol marker coloring and you want to learn more about it, there are some really talented people on YouTube that use alcohol markers. And honestly, it doesn't matter what alcohol markers you use, all the concepts apply. So if you're interested, then go there. I do own Copic markers, full disclosure. Before Stampin' Up! Created Stampin' Blends, I had alcohol markers, Copics, and I still have them. I don't use them because now I use the Stampin' Blends. And here's the deal. Stampin' Blends are like a gateway drug. They are the marker that you would choose to use if you weren't sure if it was something you wanted to get into. And here's why. A combo pack of Stampin' Blends markers is $9. One Copic marker, depending on the color, can be $9. And then you have to buy the refill for another $6 to $9. So having a collection of Copic markers is extremely expensive. Oh, here's the trick. So I wanted light pink for the inside of the ears. So I just took my color lifter and I ran it over the top of my real red marker and then added the pink to the ears. That's it. So super simple. Copics are a huge investment. I mean, you're looking at, I don't know, there's 300 and something markers. Times that by anywhere from $6 to $12 per marker, because it depends on the color. Then multiply out how many refills you need to refill those colors or replace the marker. It gets expensive quick. So these markers, the Stampin' Blends from Stampin' Up, I've heard a lot of artists and people say like, oh, they're lame, they're not good, they're this, they're that. Well, they're not meant for like, it's comparing apples and oranges, right? I mean, it's like when you get a BB gun as a kid, okay, some of you might be like anti-gun. I'm sorry, I'm gonna reference guns because it's just what popped in my head. But like a BB gun is like your beginner gun. Like I can remember when I was a kid, I got a BB gun for Christmas and we shot cans off of fences. And that was like where I started. And now I could use a 12 gauge shotgun. And I, you know, if we do like clay pigeon shooting or whatever, I can use that. So I wouldn't have started out with that as a kid because it, first of all, it would have been dangerous. But second of all, I wouldn't have known how to handle a gun. So anyway, this situation for the markers, it's probably, I feel like this is a very extreme comparison. I'm sorry. But also, by the way, BT dubs, I use the wrong ears. I have a problem with this, clearly, because the beaver card I made, do you all recall the beaver card? I also use the wrong ears on the beaver. So don't use these ears. They're way too big. There are smaller pointy little ears. And so I struggled here trying to figure out if I should layer the antlers first or the ears first. And I kept going back and forth. So sorry about that. Use the correct size ears and you won't have the problems I have. So anyway, so now they're like totally covered. I'm like, well, that's not going to work. So anyway, I left this part in because I wanted you to see that, you know, it happens. So use the smaller ears. So anyway, that's what Stampin' Blends are. They are your BB gun. They're the beginning marker. They are the marker that just makes life easy and simple and quick. And you can still get some really beautiful results with them. But they're not a Copic marker. They're not. And to compare them isn't really even fair because they aren't comparable. It's a totally different caliber of marker, and these are meant to be throwaways, right? You use them until they're gone and then you buy new ones. So if you think of it in that context, it will help you understand the difference, and it will also help you understand why you would want to start your investment with these. Much cheaper, you'll get a hang of it much easier because the other thing with Copics is like you have to have a freaking degree to use those things. I don't know if y'all have ever used them, but like they're complicated. You have to understand their numbering system and a lot about colors. And so these markers are simple. There's a light and there's a dark. You use the dark to create a shadow. You use the light to be lighter, and I have found a way to mix different colors together. As you saw on this, I used the bronze with the dark crumb cake. So I was able to combine those two markers in this video and for this project, and he looks great. He looks like he has little shadows, and yeah. The other thing that I did that I really didn't talk about on the candy cane is I added a little strip of light smoky slate in the areas that were white on the candy cane. I did this to create a shadow. And anytime you're coloring something white, you want to add a little bit of shadows in the white, and it will make the white look more white, if that makes sense. So here, I really didn't want my trees cut in solid cardstock. I wanted a softer look. So I decided that I was going to ink blend some trees. Now you can see my ink blending is really rough. It's okay. The whole point is for me to just get a little bit of color behind what I'm doing and then be able to use my markers to add in a little bit of shadows and stuff like that. So I'm using the crumb cake and old olive ink pads, and I'm stamping according to the color. So crumb cake is at the bottom. Obviously the tree is green, old olive at the top, stamping down. And now I've got this beautiful kind of like soft blended background for my trees. And then I can go in with my markers and add a little bit of detail here and there, which is exactly what I'm going to do. So again, I stamped more trees that I'm using on the card you're going to see today because I made more than one card. If you want to see the other cards I made, you can visit me over at my blog, loveandstampin.com, and you can see them there. Okay, story time. What do we have going on? So husband has been fishing, and I shared in an earlier video that he was doing a fishing derby the entire month of October. So he came home this weekend. He came home Sunday night, and he had caught two big fish. One was a 10 pounder. So he did enter that one in the derby. You get to enter three in the derby, and your largest of the three is the one that they use. So he entered the 10 pounder. And so he's going to be on vacation, and he is going to be at the lake for several days in a row. So that will be interesting to not have him home at all during that time. And I'm sure my daughter and I will pop out to visit him, but it will be a little difficult because she is technically in school. So I'm not sure how we're gonna manage all of that. I haven't thought that far yet. So that's what's going on with that. I did a video Tuesday showing how I organized my game cabinet that also had my husband's clothes in it. And it's interesting, some of the responses I've gotten from you guys are like crack me up about organization and just all the different things. I'm just on a kick. I don't know how long it'll last, but it's fading. I can tell already it's fading. But the good news is I've been able to get some stuff that has been driving me crazy organized while I was on the kick. Do you guys get these kicks where it's like, I think it's like fall, the changing of a season, fall and spring. I tend to get in these modes where I want to clean, organize, bake. Like spring and fall bring those things out in me. So I have been on that cleaning, organizing kick, and I can tell it's starting to fade. And I'm fine with that because honestly, it's a lot of work. But in the meantime, I've managed to get some areas in my house cleaned up and organized that have been driving me nutso. Okay, in other news, I thought that I would share a story with you about Christmas, because we're doing a Christmas video here. We got a Christmas card in the works, which, by the way, I don't know about you guys, but I literally can never have enough Christmas cards. I feel like I send 4 million Christmas cards every year. So, Christmas story. I can remember when I was a kid, there was this doll that that I wanted. And I have no idea why this card made me think of this, but it did. There was this doll that I wanted really, really, really bad. And it was in Sutter Creek. We saw it in a little boutique type shop out and about. And it was like very lifelike. And I can remember when we saw it, how badly I wanted it. And I can remember my mom being like, I'm sorry, it's just too expensive. And it was $80. And y'all, this was like in the 90s. So $80 for a doll in the 90s was a lot of freaking money. But I can remember how much she liked the doll as well. She really liked it. And it was very lifelike looking and feeling. And I must have only been 8, probably, or 9. And so anyway, Christmas morning comes. I go out. We were living with my grandparents at the time. And I go out to the tree, and I remember like looking under the tree, and then there under the tree was the little bassinet with the doll. And I think that that's the first time I realized that my mom was Santa. I want to know, when did you realize like who Santa was? Like, you know what I'm saying here. So I gotta know. Drop me a comment and let me know. But anyways, back to the story. So I can remember thinking to myself, like, there's no way that Santa got this exact same doll from that store. Like, I just knew. I just totally knew. So that is when I figured out who Santa was. But I think it was another year or so before I broke it to my mom, because I think I felt like I didn't want her to know that I knew. But yeah, so that was I wanted that doll so stinking bad. And there's all these little shops near where I live in Sutter Creek. And they're very boutique-y. They're very expensive. But they do oftentimes have really cool, unique stuff that you really can't find other places. Like, we have this really cool music shop. Music box shop. It's on Main Street. And they sell every kind of music box known to man. Not even kidding you. Like, it is unbelievable. My mother-in-law loves little trinkets and I call them tchotchkes. And she loves like anything like that. So I was thinking this year that for her, for Christmas, I might visit the music box shop and get her something. Oh, back to the card. So you see here that I doubled up my dimensionals on his head. That is because I'm going to put his bottom on snow that is popped up. And so it's because it's already got a dimensional layer, his head needed 2 layers. Does that make sense? Because I'm adding a layer to his feet. So we've got a lot of dimension happening on this card. Isn't he cute? So by the way, I didn't even give you in the pines here is what I'm using for the trees and the snow drifts. So yeah. So anyway, in the pines, that's the trees, the sentiment, and the little snow hills. FYI, you must have this set. It's not just good for Christmas. Like, you could use this any time of the year. Anyway, I digress. Back to my card and story. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I have a savings account that I started at the beginning of last year that is Christmas savings. And I try to do this every year. Well, this is like my second year being really good about it. But yeah, I am so excited that I did that because I've been contributing to it all year long. So now I am going to literally be able to just go shopping totally guilt-free, have plenty of cash to do my Christmas shopping, and I am loving that. In other news, my daughter is back to school one day a week, and so Thursdays, it's so weird. I think I told you guys this already. I drop her off at 8:40. I have to pick her up at 1, so it's literally not enough time to, like, it's not enough time to be able to come home. But at the same time, I cannot just like shop the entire time. So I have decided that I probably will do my Christmas shopping during some of it during those times, because I mean, that's a great use of time. And then I'm going to take my laptop with me so that I can write blog posts and edit videos and work on my business stuff while I'm sitting in the car, because I do have a hotspot on my phone. Okay, here he is, finished in all his glory. Isn't he the sweetest little thing? And you might notice this card is different than the one I just showed you. So if you want to see more videos from me, click either one you see here. Shop with me at shoploveandstampin.com. And I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. Thanks for tuning in and hanging out with me for a little while. See you guys later. Bye.